Hi guys, Frostfangs here, welcome back once again, of course, to the Paladins video back on the PTS, as I'm sure you're able to tell, with Yagrath here on the main screen. We're going to be covering some Damba today with his new buffs. I know I've been covering more of the healers than I usually would, but they are getting some of the most substantial buffs, and they also have usually the most interesting interactions with Yagrath against or even with her. But yeah, Maldamra's getting some pretty substantial buffs in the update, no nerfs, just all making him better in the next patch. He does combo quite well with Yagrath, with his Gourd, and also his selective heal. They both work quite well when she's rolling or if she's just going to be stationary, and he also does quite well against Yagrath with the Gourd as well, and also the stun. I've got one setup here that we're going to be running with today. I have this one, which I won't be using, but it is an interesting hypothetical loadout that you could use, so I'll go through his changes and then we'll jump into some matches. First off, he's having his right click buffed from 325 a second to 340. Not that big of a difference, but over the course of a match it should make your stat quite a bit better and will make a big difference as you add it all up. But most of the changes are with his cards. The most important one for me at least is many Gourds is going from 0.5 to 0.8, which is 1.5 seconds extra level 5. With the new buff, instead of a 7.5 second Gourd, you have a 6 second Gourd, and that's even lower with Chronos. So around 5 seconds, somewhere around there, you'll be throwing your Gourd out, and that is kind of ridiculous because it is either a huge heal or also a bit of a heal and a bit of damage in there. Pungent Gourd is also getting a bit of a buff, but I've never really seen anybody run this card, and it still won't be picked up too much, I would imagine, just because he has so many good options where it's going from 75 to 90. Venomous Gourd is going from 6 to 8% lifesteal, which is really, really good. I think they did say that it was bugged before, and now they've fixed it, so I imagine this will be picked up quite a bit at 8%. Spirit's Touch is having its ability changed. I can't remember what it was before, but it now gives 8% movement speed for 3 seconds after your F. Another pretty damn good card, but he's just got so many good options that I don't know if this will actually get used. And then finally, Snake Pit is going from 2%, which was abysmal, to 4. I imagine if it was 5 or 6, it would be pretty common. At 4, it's in a bit of a weird middle ground, but I could definitely see something like this becoming maybe a standard. But I am kind of interested to see if 4% is going to be enough, because I feel like something like this could eventually be standard, kind of like it is with a few other characters where you just permanently run the extra speed. But that won't be what I'm running with today for the same thing I said before. Damage just has so many good cards. 4 seconds off of the Gourd, 2 seconds if we miss the right click, a bunch of damage reduction, a bit of lifesteal, and a bit of increased healing. Personally, I didn't really feel like Damba needed a buff. I play him a decent amount in live, and I feel like he was in an okay spot. I'm definitely not complaining because I don't think this will make him overpowered or anything, but he's definitely going to be a way higher tiered healer because some of the other ones are just so good now that I think Damba has fallen behind a little bit, and he is a little bit more awkward to play than some of the others, especially if you consider the other buffs that are in this update. For example, I think this will put Damba a lot more in line with the other healers, but I think healers in general at the moment are just in a really, really good spot. So what I'm kind of trying to say with all this is that it's one hell of a good time to start playing Damba if you never picked him up before, if you wanted to try and play him a little bit more because of all these buffs, plus the fact that he combos with Yagrath and also deals with Yagrath pretty well. I can't imagine a better time to play him. Alright, well, 20 minutes later, finally got a match. We are on EU. We got Siege Timmermil. Shoutouts to Billy Kuda. He is on Ash. We got a Yagrath, a Vora, and an IO. Represents another Yagrath, a Lex, another Damba, a Furia, and a Drogos. A pretty good situation, I'd say, for Damba. I think I'm going to go for Wakona's Wrath, though. I'm very tempted to go for Ripened Gourd, but we do have an IO also for heals, and we don't have a crazy amount of damage, so I think this will be the better choice. We'll go for that, and then the Gourd setup. Start with Death Hands and Nimble. We've got the Baguette talent, Unyielding Pressure, Battering Ram Lifelink, so the Blessing is going to suck. Fusillade, Ripened Gourd, Discovery, and Corrosive Acid. Heal there for the Yagrath. We'll throw a Gourd over as well. Timbermill isn't the best map ever, but team comp-wise, we should be fine. It's just this map has got a lot of walls. I don't know if he's going up that way. Don't we know what the Yagrath is doing? It's definitely not as laggy as the NA games, a little bit better, but it definitely isn't perfect. I'm going to F myself back, throw a heal. Both the Yagrath's just rolling around. We hit him with a stun. Maybe we can get rid of him here. I'm going to throw the Gourd, dipped around the corner, just trying to deal a little bit of extra damage to him. Maybe Koei's gone. Now Yagrath jumped on the point, died, but at least me and the Ash are still up. Going for the ultimate just there. There we go. We got the Fury and also the Drogo. Should be able to get rid of her. We'll F ourselves in. Somehow I'm still up. Thank you for the heals, IO. There's a heal for you. Why is none of our tanks jumping on the point? I honestly couldn't tell you. We'll throw the Gourd inside for some tick damage, hit him with a reload, heal for the Yagrath. I don't know why none of them are jumping on the point. Seems like our Vora has just AFK'd. We're going to get the 0-1 here. For some reason, the tanks aren't really playing the objective all that much. I feel like we could have totally still won that round. Hello, enemy Yagrath. I guess you're going in on me a little bit here. I'm going to hit you with a reload. We've got Death Hands too. I don't think that's going to be enough to deal with you. I'm going to roll this way, throw the Q just here, just get some damage on him, heal for the Ash. She's definitely dead. I feel so small next to Yagrath. Usually, I don't feel tiny as Damba. Freaking everybody feels tiny next to Yagrath, though, so I don't know what I'm talking about. We're going to throw our ultimate in there. Don't know if that's going to do anything, but maybe. I feel like whenever you've got a Yagrath on both sides, the teamfight's just gone for bloody ever, especially with an IO and a Damba healing her up, and then Ash as well. Throw a heal onto IO and also the Gourd there for the Yagrath. There's a stun. Nice. Actually managed to get rid of the Yagrath. Nice. Heal for the Vora. We'll throw the Q just there, but she is gone. Did throw a heal on the Vora, but she's still gone. We'll throw a Gourd down there and a right click off the F to get back. I reckon once we have max Death Hands, we'll be doing a little bit better, but right now it's kind of rough. I'm just expecting to get flanked. Right click there for the IO. She's just a little bit out of the range of the Gourd. She's going to go up the top. Hello, Yagrath. I'm going to hit you with a reload. The Vora just stunned her, or the IO, I mean, and that is a crash. Nice. That's definitely because of Yagrath. I've had that happen a couple times when I haven't been recording. a video. We'll just relaunch Elsie in a sec. This video is a mess. Right, well, I've loaded back in, and that is what Yagurath looks like when she's in her F, but not really in her F. That's kind of funny. She's going to the same spot again. I think I've mentioned it before in a Damba video, but I don't blink enough. It definitely doesn't happen with every Paladin's character. Just sometimes when I play Damba and a few of the other really active, like, healers or damage characters, I just don't blink enough. F myself over here so I can throw a heal to the IO. We'll throw the Gore down there. We don't have max death hands just yet, but that is a stun. Just going to get some more damage on her here. She's nearly gone. I'm going to F myself in, managed to dodge the thing. There's a Q and also a right click. Thank you, IO, for the heals. I appreciate the huge plays. I'm going to F myself across. There's another right click. Don't know why the Yagurath isn't playing the point, but there's a heal for her. I guess she's going to go play closer to there. Yagurath. Hello, Yagurath. There's my Gord. Funnily enough, though, our IO is still throwing the rune on the point. She doesn't cap it anymore. That was one of the biggest balance things in this update, which I mentioned before. Kind of funny seeing her still do it. There's the ultimate heal for the Ash and some shots over there on the legs. He's actually gone. There is my F, but I'm dead too. The Yagurath, we did get 81% of it with the recovery mechanic there. I feel like we should have had it. You're there for the Vora. Gonna get a reload here on the Yagurath. Never mind, I'm gonna get ulted instead. I don't think I can actually do anything. I think I'm just dead because no one's dealing any damage to her, so I am a goner. I think Aya was trying to heal me, but I did mention in the chat that Luna doesn't push the objective anymore, because I don't know if everybody knows that, because if you don't read through the patch notes, obviously you wouldn't, and because it seems like Yagurath and Ash aren't bothering to play the objective because they think that Luna's pushing it or capping it or whatever. But with a right click for her again, she's going for the ultimate. I don't know if I can actually heal her when she's doing that. I don't think I can. That's another really weird part about the ultimate, is that you can't heal her when she's doing the ultimate thing, and you can't damage the person either. It makes no sense. The ultimate just there on the Damba, hit him with a stun. There we go. Very cheeky kill. We'll hit the Yagurath with a stun as well. Nice. She's just going to have to stop there. Just going to spam my reload, I guess. That's a tactic. There goes the Furia. Yagurath's doing laps. There's a stun. There's another one. With honestly, my Gord having like 6 seconds of freaking cooldown is ridiculous considering how long the duration is. Heal for the IO at the back. I'm going to go for the ultimate. Maybe that'll push them off the point. Stun for the Drogos. He's gone for his last hit. There we go. Ultimate worked out. Probably could have saved it, but that guaranteed the 2-2. I didn't want to risk getting the 1-3. So far, though, I'm healing for a ridiculous amount, just in case you weren't able to tell. And also, spamming the stun is really, really good fun against the Yagurath. I feel like I'm countering her quite a bit. She doesn't have any resilience, so we're just sending her for a turn. There is the Gord and also the right click. We'll throw one onto the Vora. Lex is just there at the back, hitting with the stun as he slid in, and he is a goner. Nice. Heal for the Vora. We'll throw the Q over, not a Vora. Heal for the IO. We'll stun the Yagurath. Miss the second one, but it's fine. Yagurath's going to go push up. Ash is all the way in. I guess we can leave the IO to do it. There's a heal. Guess I'm going to leave IO to do the objective. There's a double stun. Nice. We'll just hit him with another 700. Made the Yagurath retreat. I'm going to throw the ultimate just there. I don't know if we're going to hit anybody other than the Lex. I guess we've got the Furia as well. She should be gone here. There's the Gord. Hello, Lex. We'll go ahead and finish the job, I guess. Cool. Okay, I did die on the point, but that's not good. There's the double stun. And okay, cool. So we lost IO, but we got rid of all of them. That worked out great. I'm really not blinking enough. My eyes are dry as shit. But that is the objective captured. For some reason, when I play Damba, I just like go into tryhard mode, because I used to play him all the time in like ranked stuff. And especially right now, I'm kind of playing as both. I'm playing as damage Damba and also healer Damba. Lex is going around the side. There's a stun for the Furia, who I didn't even see, but she's gone. Heal for the Ash. We'll throw a reload up there for the Drogos. Can we finish him off? Yes, we can. That's a very cheeky double. Sadly, they did get rid of the IO. There's a double stun for the Lex. I am a goner. Fair enough. I felt like I lived for way too long there. We'll grab some more Chronos. Not Yagurath's just there on the edge. There's a stun. IO is also doing some stuff. We deal so much goddamn damage. For some reason, I forget how much damage you deal with stun down, but there's a combo on the Drogos. We got rid of him. Hit one on the Furia just there. We'll go ahead and throw the ultimate kind of midway through. Can we finish her off at the back? No. The Gord didn't manage to finish off the IO. IO is trying to ult the Yagurath. I also meant to say Furia there. I'm going to throw another reload. Doesn't even matter. Excellent. Fully ult. Got rid of the Yagurath. Trying to hit the stun on the Drogos up top. There we go. That should be enough to finish him off. Nearly finished him off. He's on like no health. Hit it again. He's on like nothing. For some reason, I'm playing here as like a damage dealer and also a healer and also the person pushing the objective. It's kind of silly. Stun for the Yagurath. She should be dead here. Luna stun as well. We'll throw the Gord on the floor for some tick damage and just throw some reloads. He's going for the ultimate team. Give me a hand. She's somehow not taking any damage here from my team. I guess nobody bothered to hit her. Okay. You're there for the Yagurath. We'll throw the Gord. Spam some reloads over. Maybe that can make our Yagurath live, but she's getting hit from everywhere. I'm just going to jump on it to trigger the overtime. F myself in. Throw the Gord. Heal 44. She's going for the ultimate. Definitely weren't going to get that one, so I saved the ultimate. So that is the 3-3. We're going the full distance. I don't know when Ash ulted. She must have done it right as I died. Same thing with the Yagurath. Then Vora used it right at the end. The Vora is just saying effing abusers. I don't really know what they're abusing. To be honest, they're just playing pretty standard. Maybe I'm missing something. Yeah, even our Yagurath there saying abusing what? She said point heals, so shoot the healers. Yeah, I agree with Yagurath there. I don't understand how she could complain about the heal when Furia and Damba are just kind of chilling for free. You're there for the IO. We'll throw the Gord over for the Damba. I'm going to throw my ultimate at the back. I also just called our Yagurath the Damba because my brain Bane is huge. I just wasted my ultimate, but I wanted to get it off early. I'm going to roll in, heal for the Ash. Chasing down the legs. There's a stem for the damage instead. He's gone. Never mind. I feel like I should have got that one. A little bit cheesy. Can we hit him with the second full reload? Yes, we can. Fantastic. Yagrath finished him off. Throw the gourd over. We have literally a 5 second gourd right now. Our heals are ridiculous. Our IO died to somebody. I'm going to jump onto the point. Heal there for the IO. Yagrath is running in. There's a stand. There's another one. I'm going to throw the gourd. I'm going to F myself over this way. I think Lex might try and chase, or maybe not. There's a stun for him. Can we shut him down? Yes, we can. Heal for the Yagrath. Throw the gourd. Ash went fully ult, so did Yagrath. Got rid of the Drogos. I think I would have actually been able to kill him faster than the animation on that ultimate. I don't feel like I touched that. Is that going to get me killed? I thought I was going to die there. There's a gourd and also the heal, but that is going to be the 4-3. Well deserved win, I would say. I played very, very actively then. I'm really glad I got a chance to show off the new buff to Dambert. He plays so goddamn nicely with this. It's even more ridiculous when you realize how much he combos with Yagrath and also counters Yagrath there. We went 16-8, 1560 seconds on the point, 110k damage, which is highest on our side. We only beaten out there by the Lex and also 100k heals. For the rest of them, our Ash did pretty good. Our IO did a decent job. So did our Vora. Our Yagrath played a little bit weirdly, but didn't do too bad. Their Drogos did okay. Their Lex shredded, although we were able to deal with him because we went for stun Damber. Their Furia and their Damber both did a pretty good job, and so did their Yagrath. Overall, really, really solid game, although I think we do deserve the win. To be completely honest with you, I feel like I could leave it just there with that one match because we did damage Damber. We did healer Damber. I did objective Damber. I did everything I possibly could there, and you can kind of see with the stat. I'm really happy with how that match went. Let's jump into game two. Note to self, freaking blink more when I play Mal'Damber, or when you play Mal'Damber. I don't know if anybody else out there needs to hear that, but I definitely do, because I do not blink enough when I play him. For some reason, he's the one character that I'm always super active with. I can't just chill. And that was by far one of the most active Damber matches I played in a minute, and these buffs are just ridiculous. But we've got another Siege Timber Mill. Shoutouts to our Lian and possibly also our Cassie. We then have a Yagrath and a Lex, and we're up against another Yagrath, a Pit with Ceres and Amani, and an Andro. So pretty good situation here to go for healer Damber. We'll focus with Frypan to Gordon to a bit more of a focus on the healing side of things. Saying that though, I am very tempted to go for Wakona's Wrath just because that bonus damage allows you to do fights like kind of one-on-one without your team's help. So I guess just to make it a bit more different, we'll go for Frypan to Gordon, heal for as much as we can instead of focusing on damage or whatever. We'll go for Kronos to start and Nimble for the talents. We've got Discovery, Alacrity, Big Game, and then Baguette Talent, Curse of Volver, Mega Potion, Corrosive Acid, Soul Collector, and Mana Rift. Through the Gourd, but that didn't really do anything. Stun for the Yagrath. That feels so goddamn slow. Heal for the Yagrath. Throw the Gourd down in the middle. There's another heal for her. She's just got so much goddamn sustain there on the point with us there. The amount of sustain we can freaking provide with this setup here is ridiculous with the 5 second cooldown on the goddamn Gourd. Stun the Yagrath. There's the Q. Heal for the Leon as well. I'm trying to reload again, but don't even need to. She's already gone. Heal for her, and there is the objective captured. Nice. We'll throw the Gourd and hit her with a right click. Roll into the Gourd, kind of hide behind the Yagrath a little bit so the Andro can't get rid of me. That's an interesting tactic I've never actually done before with any of the other characters, but kind of works with this because we can throw the heal down and kind of hide in her a little bit. Throw the Gourd. She's actually being pushed by the objective. Trying to avoid the Andro as best as I can without dying here. There's a heal for the Lex. Yagrath is just running around the top. We'll throw a Gourd on the point. There's a right click for her. Not sure exactly what she's going for. There's another right click. There's the Gourd. I'm going to F myself into it. Try to stun the Ceres, but that feels so slow. Just going to stand in my Gourd. Throw a heal. That Ceres going for the heal. F to dodge. Genuinely having such a low cooldown on the Gourd means you can pretty much permanently have a Gourd out. I think the duration is like 5 or 6 seconds. So having a 5 second cooldown on the Gourd means you permanently have an area with that much healing. Just going to F on to trigger the overtime, I guess. Get myself a free death. I have no idea what the team's doing. Everybody's just kind of sitting at the back waiting for something to happen. Right, well, there is the one once. Go ahead and jump into round two. One thing I've noticed a ton on the PTS is just people are kind of not paying attention too much and people lose points just like we did there because no one was really bothering to jump on the objective and everyone was just sitting waiting for something to happen. Throw the Q just there. She can't actually be healed, but she's going for the ultimate. She of course died because the ultimate isn't a very good ability. There is the Gourd and a right click for her. She can just tank that. I don't know why she's bothering to reposition, but throw the Gourd down there for the Cassie. Throw a heal as well because for some reason Yagrath isn't interested in playing the point, I suppose. We'll throw another Gourd. We can pretty much permanently, like I said, have a Gourd on the objective healing people. It's mad. Right click there for the Cassie. She went for the ultimate. We'll throw a Gourd kind of forward if she wants to push up, but I don't think that's a great idea. Yagrath is just doing laps, kind of like what Ram would do. There's a heal to her all the way over there. Throw the Gourd. Don't know where that Andro is, but there's a heal to the Cassie. Go for the ultimate just there so she can live and maybe get rid of somebody. Well, no, Yagrath died by pushing up weirdly. I'm dead here any second. Yagrath's just going to de-deploy or not. I guess I live to see another day here because the enemy team just wasn't really bothered to get rid of me. There's a right click for the Yagrath. She got rid of the Andro, or I guess Ceres did, not Ceres, Lian. I was trying to call out the ultimate. There's a heal for the Yag again. Heal for the Lian. I'm going to F myself in. Throw the Q. Maybe we can get rid of this Amani. I don't think she can actually kill me if I'm standing in my heal. We're actually making her retreat. Nice. Thanks, Lex, for the backup. Gourd's just there for the Yagrath in the corner. Healed the Cassie. Heal for the Lian. We'll throw a Q. Andro's going for the ult. I'm just going to tank one or two of them and then go into the F, or just all of them. Heal for the Lian. Gourd near the point. Cassie is gone. If Yagrath just played the objective here, this match would already be over, I think. Get rid of this Amani if we can. Well done, Lian. She went for the ultimate. Didn't even hear it. That's probably just me, though. There's a stun. Never mind. Just going to keep making the push here. There's a heal for her. Lex is up top. I'm pretty sure he's dead. Heal for the Yagarath. Guess I'm here pushing the point, even though Yagarath is just doing that. There's a right click and also the Q over there. Is she going to deploy or what? There's a heal for the Lian. No, she's just going to keep rolling. Why? Seems like a lot of people who play Yagarath don't realize that you don't really do very much when you're rolling around. It's just usually you can reposition because the right click deals damage and the spit does a little bit, but you don't really do anything else. Like, I've seen a hell of a lot of people just kind of roll around not using their abilities, trying to hit people, dealing damage like that, which isn't how it works. Like, instead of deploying on the objective, they'll kind of just roll around like he's doing now, trying to hit people as if that does anything. It's understandable. She's obviously the new character, so obviously it's going to be a bunch of stuff like that. It definitely doesn't happen all the time, as you saw in game one, but it happens more than I actually expected it to. Heal there for the Cassie. Let's just keep it going. We'll throw a Gourd as well. Right click for the Yagarath. I don't know why she deploys up here. She has really crappy range. That's the other thing people also seem to not get with Yagarath, is you do have to be very close to do anything. There is the Gourd. She's going for the ult. Pip went for the ult. I think they are all fine though, or maybe not. We'll throw the Gourd just in case. Heal for the Yag. That Amani melted me. Right click for the Lian. That is Yagarath. Real close. There is the heal. I don't really know what she did there, but the Gourd is giving me some freaking big numbers. Throwing out some big heals, but again, nobody really bothering to play the objective. Yagarath just kind of rolling around aimlessly. We'll throw the Gourd here for myself just so that I don't die. I have no idea what's going on. The awareness of my team is just kind of strange. There's a Q. Their awareness is also kind of weird. Use the F to dodge the Ceres again. I've done that every single time because why wouldn't I? That's the Amani dragon who's just kind of flying around trying to protect herself. I think there's the F again. I'm going to throw my ultimate just so that I don't die. Right click for the Yagarath who's just rolling, kind of. Really have no idea what's going on. That's probably the worst Yagarath I've seen actually. We're F over here. Heal for the Lex, but I am a goner. I'm doing the best I can here with Damba, but that is the 2-3. I wish I went for the damage one here. It would have made a way bigger difference because even though I'm healing for a lot, my team isn't really doing any damage. So I'm kind of left without really being able to do very much, especially with how many situations I've been in here where I feel like I could have shredded if I was going for damage Damba. Heal for the Liam, which I was trying to get to the Lex, but that's fine. There's a heal to the Lex. Hello, Amani. I'm going to F myself. Heal for the Cassie. I'm actually confused here. I don't know who's a person and who isn't because some people are playing really, really like how bots would play, especially the Yagarath. I think Yagarath might be a bot. Maybe that would explain why she's just playing so bloody weird. I don't think I've really had much experience with it, so I'm not really sure, but there's some big heals. There is another one. There is another Gourd. Okay, we've got a 4-second Gourd right now because of the Max Chronos. So we permanently have something on the floor here, healing for massive amounts. We'll throw the Gourd there. Yagarath is just moving weird again. I'm going to F myself across. Heal for the Lex. We'll go up top and throw the Gourd. Instantly bad idea. There is the ultimate though, so maybe we're fine. Ceres going for the ult, which I didn't hear. F myself here. Throw the Gourd. Jump. Heal. Okay, I guess we're somehow fine. Heal for the Lian. I don't know how the hell we held this one. Throw the Gourd just here. Right click for the Lian. F myself in. Hello, Amani. I'm just going to go here. There's a heal to try and get rid of her with the stun, but that didn't work. Either way, Lex gave me a hand. There's the Gourd down there. Right click. I guess you can actually walk on here. That's good to know. I don't know if this is intentional or not, but this is an interesting little spot to be. And there we go. 3-3. It seems like we've had another pretty damn good match. I just feel a little bit helpless because I'm not on damage Damba. If I was playing damage Damba here, this would have been a win already. But playing as healer Damba, I'm relying on my team a little bit more, and it's a little bit strange for me, but I feel like we're healing for a ton. We'll finish off our Nimble. I don't know if death hands would have made a bigger difference. Wait, hold on. Yagarath's just asking there, is the floor invisible to anybody else? Yeah, no, it's not for me either. It's because you have low graphics. Yeah, weird bug. So I guess if you have low graphics with Yagarath or this map, you don't have a floor. That's the first time I've heard anybody mention that, and I read through all the comments on my other BTS videos that I've been up so far, so surprised that's the first time I've heard any mention of it, but okay. That would definitely explain why the Yagarath is playing so weird, because you can't see the floor. I'm going to F myself in so I can get a heal to her, just in case she needs it. We'll throw the Gourd, and also that right click, she's using her immunity, so she should be fine. The healing numbers there are pretty nice. Right click for the Lian. Right click for the Yagarath as she rolls away. We'll throw a Gourd down there, but I think I'm a little bit too late. Heal for the Cassie. We can F ourselves over. Heal for the Yagarath again. Throw the Gourd down. There's another right click. Honestly, these cooldowns are kind of mental. Pip went for the ult. There's another heal for the Yagarath. I guess she kind of counters Pip ult. The Cassie's just kind of chilling. There's a Gourd. There's no way she should die here unless she just takes a silly amount. Heal for her again. There's the Gourd. I guess she did get kind of bursted. Lian's just moving kind of weird. Yagarath all the way over there. Cheeky little stun for her and a couple little taps. There's another heal. There's a Q. I don't know if we're going to be able to jump back on this, but I'm going to use the F for the movement. Heal for the Yagarath as she runs in. Right click for the Lian. The Yagarath is also rolling through. We'll throw the Gourd. There's the heal. We'll go for the ultimate as well. Heal for the Yagarath. Why isn't she deploying? What's happening right now? Heal for the Lian. Heal for the Cassie as well. I'm throwing out as much as I can here, honestly, but I don't know if we're going to get it or not. I'm going to F myself across. Gourd just here. I think I'm dead, though, to the Andro because he's right in the back line. I think even if I had my F there, I'd have been screwed. Is Ceres going for the ult? She's pulling the Lian. What do I go for? I guess blast shields? I don't think it's going to matter. We're on 93, 96, 99, 87 on theirs. There's a heal for the Yagarath and also the Q down there for it. There's a right click for the Cassie. Are we actually going to get this? I totally thought we were screwed, but there is the 4-3 victory. All right, fantastic. There is the win. Totally thought we were going to lose that one, but the team kind of stepped up there in the last round. I feel like I healed for quite a bit. I was entirely focused on healing there, and the stat definitely shows you that. I didn't really deal any damage, but I healed for 186k, which I am more than happy with. I feel like I healed for way less than that. We went 1517. Not that impressive of a stat, other than the objective time, which is way higher than it should have been there, and also the healing, which is quite a lot. I feel like we basically traded off damage there for the heals, and I feel like that worked. Akas Genasi did okay, definitely could have done a little bit better. Lex didn't do too bad. The Lian shredded. The Yagarath had a really hard time. Their Yagarath also had a bit of a hard time, didn't do too bad. Their Seraph did pretty good. Their Pip also did decent. Their Andra did okay, and then their Amani shredded. And there we go. That was the new buffed Damba. I feel like I showed this off very, very well just from the stats alone. I would be kind of disappointed in myself if I didn't do a good job of showing this off, because he is actually my highest level character just from having played him so much, and I had a ton of fun. He's honestly in such a good spot with these buffs. Would I say that it's too much? Probably not, because Damba, I'd say in Alive, is in a pretty good spot and doesn't really get played very much at all, so this will hopefully bring him into being played at least a little bit, because I feel like with this he is one hell of a healer. Let me know your thoughts, of course, in the comments. I'm interested to hear from you guys on this one, because my opinions are pretty obvious. I love Maldamba. If I had to give a favorite character, he might be the one I'd choose. He'd definitely be in my top three. I don't really have a favorite character anymore, but he definitely used to be my favorite character, and I've said that loads of times. So yeah, this has been one hell of an active video, but I hope you have enjoyed it. I certainly have. Thanks so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed, of course. Let me know what you want to see me do next. I'll see you guys all very, very soon, and as always, stay frost there.